Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we discuss about a very interesting topic which is recently launched in Confluence. So here we will walk you through how we can use that features and make our life easy. So if you wanted to learn more about Jira and Confluence, feel free to add my Jira and Confluence playlist within your regular watch repository, where you can get detailed understanding about Jira and Confluence. I've also created one course on Graphi, that is, you'll be able to access this course from raigurukul.graphi.com, where you'll have detailed understanding about how we can use Jira as a Scrum Master and Project Manager. This will give you a detailed insight. Feel free to get this course in very less cost, that is $5.99 for India and $9.99 for out of India user. Now, here, coming back to new features in Confluence, I was talking about Confluence integration with Google Meet. This is a recently added functionality in Confluence where we can access Confluence through Google Meet meeting. Let's understand, we are connected on any important meeting which requires to draft all those informations in any documents to have the access to each and every of the participants. In that case, Confluence is the best place to manage the centralized repository, and we can note down all those meeting notes and important topics on Confluence and share with any of our team member. So here, how we can do that, I will explain you in detail. Now, first, we have to integrate with Google Meet. For integrations, navigate to your Google Workspace and from there, install Confluence. You have to search for Confluence and click on install. I've already installed, that's why I'm able to see this added in my Google Meet or Google. Now, after that, whenever we will launch a new meeting, I'm just starting a meeting. This meeting will have the Confluence available. Let me disable this. And from here, in the activities, you can see Confluence available. Let me explain you how we can use it for our regular group. So here you can see, once I will click on Confluence, here we can get create Confluence page. Now, in that case, it will ask me to select my instance first, our user ID, and post that it will ask me to enter my instance or select my instance. Once I will select, click on finish and refresh, we have this page available. We have to just click on start activity, and from here we will be able to add any of those screen. I can also share the Confluence page to the screen where people will be able to watch my data, whatever I am typing. Let's consider we are drafting project plan. So here I've defined project plan exactly similar way whatever we are using in Confluence, exactly same thing we can use it from here as well. So inside the project plan, I will specify detailed project. So here I wanted to add feature one. So based on the discussions, we can note down each and every pointer in detail. And this will help us to showcase to entire team who is participating this call so that everyone will be on same page. So I will include feature one, feature two, feature three, and feature four. Now let's target only these things. If I wanted to add any of macros, I will also mention that. Add my name, we will be able to mention it, and this person will be a project manager. Now, in terms of project plan, we can also showcase other details like team member. So we can also define dev team, QA team, and UAT team. If we have the black backlog systems, whichever backlog we have created for related to that project, we can also include it here. So exactly similar way, whatever we are building at the time of Confluence pages, exactly same thing. We can use it from Google Meet as well. How this will help us in real life? Let's take one example. We are trying to get project from one of our client, and those clients are not having any platform where we can documents and share these documents with them. So in that case, we will use this platform where we can draft all those discussion points and share with them for the approval. And once they will confirm, these documents will become initial document for us where we can use it on our regular day-to-day activity. Even from start to end of this project, we can utilize these documents as a reference, what we have discussed initially. This will also help us track each and every pointer in a centralized manner where team is getting update whenever anyone makes changes. In that case, this will also help us to draft their initial discussion pointer, which might be they won't be able to update it in futures, or for any additional request, they have to go ahead with the change request. If we'll consider this as a baseline, so drafting everything in front of complete participants and taking approval immediately will help us to avoid any last moment changes. Here, once we are done, we'll make it to publish, and this will take few seconds. This page will be published, and even though exactly same settings which we are getting in Confluence blog and pages, we'll have this here. If anyone wants to add the comment, they will get exactly same page to add the comment. So I add here as a comment. Now you can see if I added the comment, this comment will be visible to other people or other participants within this. So this will be a game changer at the time of team meetings or stakeholder meetings or any project planning where we are connecting on the regular basis. Once the page will be created, we can use it whenever and wherever we want. Even we can also utilize these documents for our regular scrum call. So let's say I wanted to draft all those meeting notes on scrum DSV calls notes on Confluence pages. That also possible to do it. If we are doing any marketing stuff and we are planning and we have joint call with complete organization, that also possible to draft the meeting notes. If we are sitting with client first time and we wanted to draft all those requirements in one page and share with them for the final confirmations, hey, these are the requirements, please check and confirm, did we understood properly? That is also possible. If we are maintaining any documents and we want to present it, we can also show it via using this. So this will be a game changer when we are working with centralized document repository. This will help us to streamline all of our activities in front of every participants. This will also help us to avoid last moment changes as well as creating any confusion in futures. So that's all about this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.